Hello and welcome to QuickerSim CFD Toolbox tutorial number 23, Inhomogeneous Velocity Inlet Profiles. In this tutorial, I will demonstrate how to prescribe a boundary condition that requires the velocity in the inlet not to be a constant value, but rather to vary across the inlet. Now, our first example is going to be Hagen-Pouisseile flow, or flow through a cylindrical pipe. Flow in such a pipe is parabolic, as you can see in this picture. This is the analytical solution. And the profile of this flow can be described using this formula. Here, u0 is the maximum velocity. It is, of course, reached at the axis of the pipe, at the middle of the pipe. And capital R is the radius of the pipe. So let's go straight into MATLAB. And I'll show you our specific example. Let's clear anything I had previously. Let's import and read the mesh and display it right here. Mesh is a cylinder. It is of radius 0.002 and of length 0.03. It is important to note that the z-axis is the axis of the cylinder. So let us next convert the mesh to the second order and define the viscosity of the fluid and initiate our solution. This has already been covered in the previous tutorials concerning laminar flow. If you have not yet seen them, it is recommended that you do so that you can follow along and know exactly what's happening. So next, we're going to define the parameters required for defining the profile. R is the radius of the pipe, and Vmax is our maximum velocity from the formula seen here. So let us define these. And in this section, it's the crucial section, we are going to define the velocity profile. Now, the way to apply this profile, one of the ways to apply this profile, is to give the function impose CFD boundary conditions the argument here, velocity or vel cylindrical. This is an array that defines the velocity at every node of the mesh, not just the inlet. This is actually done for the user's simplicity because it is easier to define the velocity using the entire rows of array P rather than having to extract the inlet nodes. So the extraction of the inlet nodes is done by the function impose CFD boundary conditions. You do not have to worry about that. So right here we are defining the X and Y components of velocity. They are zero, of course, because the axis of our pipe is the same as the z-axis. And here we are simply defining the z-component. It corresponds directly to this formula once again. Here the radius at which the node lies is defined by this part of the code right here. This is done simply by applying the Pythagorean theorem, of course. We're taking a square root of this and then just taking the square of it. This is obviously redundant. It is simply done to directly show that this part right here is the radius at which the nodes lie. So next, we are going to run this portion of the code. And we're going to continue with our main iterative loop. Here we are assembling the Navier-Stokes matrix, and we're using stabilization. So our problem is going to be stabilized. And next, we are applying the boundary conditions. So as you can see, here we are providing the velocity profile for every node as our argument. And once again, this function impose CFD boundary condition will simply extract the necessary nodes. And we're plotting the residuals, and this is our stop criterion. So let's just run the iterative loop. And this will take a couple of seconds, of course. Perfect. So our solution has converged. Now let us just display the results. Here, let's actually talk about this first. This is obviously just the Z velocity. So let's just display that real quick. No surprises here. The velocity has a parabolic profile. It only varies with the radius. But this, perhaps this picture is not too informative. We can't really see what's inside. So what we are going to do next is we are going to look at a cross-section of our problem. This function right here, map onto plane, what it does, it takes our mesh, obviously. So these are the P and T arrays. It takes the values of the field we wish to display. In this case, it is the Z velocity field. Next, it takes the normal vector to the plane that we wish to map our results onto, so we wish to section our mesh with. And in order to define this plane, we also need a point that belongs to it. So once again, this is the normal vector, and this is an arbitrary point that belongs to it. So let's run this portion of the code. Takes 2 seconds, and as you can see, these are the results that we expected. The profile is parabolic, which cannot necessarily be seen here, but I assure you it is parabolic, simply because, as you can see, it is the same as the inlet, and we defined the inlet velocity as parabolic, and it is constant across the entire section, so we have validated our problem and we have achieved a correct solution. So next we are going to look at a rectangular problem. This is defined by this function right here, the inlet velocity. It is not the analytical solution to this problem. So you will actually see that the solution across the geometry or far away from the inlet will actually differ from the prescribed inlet velocity. Not a great deal, but it will differ. So this is the idea behind our boundary condition. This is the visualization of this formula. The process is exactly the same, so I will simply run this code and we can look at the results. So while this is calculating, let's just double check the mesh. This will not update until the next iteration. Perfect. So here, as you can see, the cross-section of the pipe in this case is rectangular. Let's close this and wait for the calculations to finish. Perfect. And we are done. So first, let's just take a quick look at our results. So obviously, the sort of general outlet profile here is as expected, but let's take a look at the specific values and how it looks across the cross section. So the mesh in this case is not particularly fine, which is why this is not perhaps the best quality. However, as you can see, there is a difference here between the inlet and the outlet. As mentioned, the prescribed velocity profiles are not the analytical solution to the flow, so naturally the flow changes further away from the inlet. This concludes our tutorial. Thank you for tuning in. If you would like to learn more, please visit our website at quickersim.com. Please also check out our YouTube channel for more tutorials, and be sure to like us on Facebook and follow us to learn news and updates.